Yo, what's up guys? Raymond here. Today we're going to talk about Vanguard Index Funds for beginners or people who are looking to get started in investing in index funds. So the question now is, what are Vanguard Index Funds? Index funds are mutual funds that investors can buy shares in. So the fund mimics or tracks a benchmark or index, for example, the S&P 500, REITs, which is real estate investment trusts. We have growth stocks, we have bonds. So whatever you're into, you can probably find an index fund that tracks that certain index. Index funds also contain hundreds, if not thousands, of stocks within a particular fund. Cool thing about index funds too is that it's really for regular working class, just normal people. And it makes it very simple for someone like that to get started in investing without all the hassle and all the know-how and all the technical knowledge required. So instead of an individual going out on their own, doing their own research on stocks like Google, Tesla, Amazon, whatever they're interested in, and poring over, you know, earnings statements and forecast and listening to the news, CNBC, whatever, they don't even need to do that. All they need to do is just go on Vanguard, find a index fund that they're interested in investing in with the stocks that they might be interested in, that tracks whatever index that they're interested in tracking, and then just invest in that index fund instead of trying to do individual stock picks. So for example, if you were to invest in a total stock market index fund, then if you buy a share of that index fund, then you will have exposure to the total stock market, just as the name suggests. For example, a super popular Vanguard index fund that tracks the total stock market index is called VTSAX. One thing to note is that index funds do have a minimum investment requirement, so make sure you take that into consideration. You can buy ETFs or exchange traded funds, but that's outside of the scope of this video. I do have a couple of videos linked down in the description below if you are interested in getting started on ETFs. So index funds, again, are for just your regular average person, and it's a passive way to get started investing. They are just interested in getting the average return on their investment in the market. They aren't concerned with beating the market or trying to double their money in 6 months or anything like that, okay? So index funds are for regular people, people that work, have families, kids, other responsibilities. The last thing somebody wants to do is go out, work 8, 10, 12 hours, come home, and then they have to pore over earnings reports and forecasts for individual companies and try to time the market or, you know, pick stocks that they think are going to go up. That's very time consuming. It's extremely complex. And in most cases, in my opinion, 9 times out of 10, you're probably going to end up losing money anyway if you try to, you know, chase stocks and, you know, try to get into what's hot now. Don't do it if you can, all right? Passive investing into index funds is a very simplified approach. You can check it, you know, once a year if you want, you know, biannually if you want, and then just focus your attention on other things, all right? You don't constantly need to monitor your portfolio with this type of investing. So you might be wondering, why Vanguard? There are so many investment companies out there. Who cares about Vanguard? Why not Fidelity, for example? Why not Schwab, for example? The fact is, Vanguard has some of the lowest fees in the industry. Their expense ratios are about 75% lower than the industry average. So that's something to take note of. I am not sponsored by Vanguard. This is my own personal opinion. I've been with Vanguard for over 10 years at this point, and I've never had an issue with them. I highly recommend them as an investment company. Another thing to note is that about 85% of their mutual funds have outperformed their competitors over the last 10 years. You also have a huge variety of index funds to choose from. So this allows people with different risk appetites and investment goals to pick and choose which funds they want to invest in that suits them. Now, the question becomes, so why index funds? Why not real estate or cryptocurrency or any of those other investments? Why do index funds? Look, the fact is, actively managing your investments or your investment portfolio is extremely complex. It's extremely time consuming, okay? Even for professionals, professional money managers have a tough time getting good returns for their clients, okay? Passive investing just allows us via index funds to just look into the fund once a year, a couple times a year, whatever that might be, pick an index fund to invest in, and then just forget about it for a while. You don't need to be constantly in and out of the market, buying this hot stock, going over here, buying this thing. It's unnecessary, all right? You just passively invest into a fund and then you don't think about it anymore. Another thing that makes index funds very good is that they're very consistent. If you look at performance over the last 10 years or so, you can see that every year the returns have been pretty consistent, right? But just take note, last 10 years we have been in a bull market, so pretty much anyone could have made money if they just put their money out there, to be honest. So just take that with a grain of salt when you're considering investing in these funds, because past performance isn't always indicative of future performance. And the final thing that makes index funds really good is that they have extremely low fees. You know, index funds don't have a portfolio manager to constantly buy and sell stocks out of the fund. They're just not, you know, focused on trying to beat the market. They're just trying to get the average market return. So whatever the index does that they're tracking, whatever that does, that's what the fund will do as well. Okay, so I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, I encourage you to please share it with a friend or a family member that might find it useful as well. Also consider hitting that like and subscribe button, and also hit the notification icon to be notified each time I upload a video. I do upload videos multiple times a week on personal finance and investing, so I hope to see you in the next video. Peace. Thank you.